Before I start with the main topic, let me have a little introduction on how EPSTP, the Farmer Scientist Training Program, came into being. After more than 20 years of operation of our corn-based Farmer Scientist RDA Training Program, EPSTP, which started in 1994 in Argao, Cebu, as a national program, and since 2008, indeed, there are now a number of success stories that Sherpa wanted me to focus on for our seminar this afternoon. However, before presenting our EPSTP success stories, let me give you first a brief background on how EPSTP came into being. This program has evolved from failures of several extension countryside action programs of the College of Agriculture, UPLB, in the 1970s, 1980s, and 1990s, where billions of pesos had been spent from foreign sources of funds like USAID, JICA, World Bank, and from the Department of Agriculture. These programs were implemented in various pilot provinces and municipalities to address poverty and food shortage problems of the country. Apparently, this has little or no substantial effects on the poverty and leisure of our people. Until now, the government imports more rice and still more people do not have enough food to eat, especially those in the upland mountainous communities where most farmers are still the poorest of the poor. More than 40% of our people are still in the poverty level. Now, the main reason for this failure of the UPLB agricultural development projects is the lack of sustainability. These were implemented as pilot projects in selected sites in the province of Manipur municipality, usually in areas easy to reach by vehicles. This was usually for a limited period of time, about 3 to 4 years, unwithdrawn, leaving the project for the concerned LGUs to continue without any support funds left and only to be abandoned later. This is where the failure lies, because the LGUs had no funds available for the needed farm imports like fertilizer, seeds, farm implements, post-harvest facilities, all due to politics. Politicians is usually the stumbling block in our program, especially when the mayors are changing in the different parties. Now, To learn the lessons of failures of the UPLB countryside action programs, Dr. Davide, Professor of Plant Pathology and former director of the National Crop Protection Center of UPLB, conceptualized the corn-based farmers research development and extension, or RDE. This is the program where we combine research, development, and extension. We know that research group and extension are too far away, so why can't we combine the three EBC, R&D, and extension group, the screening program? And it is focused on corn and other food crops, since corn is next to rice. It's our staple food, and grown mostly in upland communities where farmers remain poor and hungry and illiterate. With the initial research grant 500,000 from DA as a part of my Gawad Saka Award as the 1994 Outstanding Agricultural Scientist. FSTP was launched in July 1994 in Kulawin National High School, Kulawin, Argao, Cebu. Kulawin was one of the poorest barangays in Argao, about 18 kilometers from the town proper, a far-flung mountainous area. I was born there and grew up in Kulawin, engaged in corn, vegetable, and fruits farming as a kid. APSTP was then a dual program of the College of Agriculture, Yopinas Banyas, the Department of Agriculture, Region 7, DOST Region 7, Cebu State College of Science and Technology, and Kulawin Education Foundation. Now, again, then Dr. Cecilio Arboleda of the College of Agriculture appointed me as project leader. And I was very happy the dean did this, because I told the dean, "Go, dean, this is the best assignment in my life." Why? Because you are sending me home to help my people. Now, our FSTP farmer graduates are referred to as farmer scientists, and are graduates of UP Los Baños Extension Program. They are our alumni. Argao at that time was a fifth plus town and one of the poorest municipalities in Cebu, which was also one of the poorest provinces in the country, with serious NPA insurgency problem, where gun armalites were the status symbol. Argao is now first class town, with farmers having cell phones as status symbols, together with their motorcycles, Sabalhaba. While the province of Cebu is now first class and one of the richest provinces in the country. Almost all towns are now expanding the FSTP training program, reaching the poorest barangays where farmers can now grow. They can now grow and harvest corn at four possible times per hectare compared to 1 to 2 times per hectare. And they are also growing vegetable, root crops, along with livestock production. Many of them are now engaged in business of farming. And they are already, they have greatly improved their living conditions above and beyond poverty level. The success of FSTP in Cebu and other provinces has prompted President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo to sign an executive order number 17 on February 27, 2008, making FSTP as a national program, giving priority to the 6th, 5th, 4th, and 3rd-class municipalities and provinces in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Our partner agencies involved are DE, DOST, DAR, DNR, LDOs, UPLB, SUCs, CHIP, and NGOs. Currently, all the 13 regions of the country have FSTP in selected depressed provinces and municipalities. However, due to very limited funds available, mainly provided by DAETI, UPNB, and NGOs, the expansion of this program is very slow. It did not get enough attention and funds from the last Aquino administration. The budget was only 10 million pesos and reduced to 5 million in 2016 and 2017. So that's our situation. And now, after this introduction, let me follow this by PowerPoint presentation of more success stories among the SPP farmers in different parts of the country. So I let Mr. Hamyas do his job in changing the different part pictures of this presentation. So,
ilagay dito, kala ko bumba eh. Ito pala, self-made, no?
So, you can look at the title.
Yes, it's a part of UCD, liberation of the farmers. This is now the success story, you know?
So, next is the you see the logo. The hands of the farmer scientists of the scientists, no? All, you know, hawak niya ang kamay ng farmers at saka NGOs. Imagine kung wala yung kamay ng scientists. Kamay lang ng farmers or NGOs or kamay ng mayor. There is no, basta yung flow of technologies, transfer technologies, mahirap at pwede dito. So, we started this in 1993. Now we have a motto, we gather knowledge to scatter. That means our graduates are required to teach fellow pilots to know and scatter what they learn. Now we have it then, empowering farmers for socio-economic progress. Okay, FSTP is a technical science-based community development program. It is focused more on corn as food staple next to rice. There are 20 million Filipinos, mostly living in upland communities, who are dependent on corn. Like Cebuanos, kami mga Cebuanos, mais talaga na ilagay namin. Kaya mahaba ang buhay. Except on corn, itaas ang vitamins niya, and it's slow release ng energy. Okay, next. Now, before going in, we have to define what is a scientist. And we have a definition from the American Journal of Scientists. But what is a scientist? See, he watches his things. Try another here. He reads. He finds out how things work and how they can be made better. He wonders. He experiments. He finds out what is true. He sees that wonderful things do indeed happen. Yun ang consumption ng scientist. But kung nangyari na yun, sabi na yung mga kaibuluan. Now, here, the word he experiments, yun ang maka-scientist yun na. Yung iba, kaya natin, yung pag-experiments, yun ang it's a problem. So we have to focus as a scientist on the experiment of one. Next. So, itong farmers ko natin, corn-based farmer scientist, research, development, extension. Training pro is based on the assumption, may assumption tayo, that there is no barren soil, only barren mine, and farming is business. And this is designed to liberate poor farmers from the bondage of poverty and hunger. Para lang ito sa mga program. Okay? Now, there is no barren soil, only barren mind. Because noong bata pa kami, yung mga Cebuanos, my question, day and night, pupunta kami ganaw dahil sa Cebu daw, barren na ang lupa. So kami, hindi na umabis kami ng father ko. You go to those barrios because there is no barren soil, only barren mines. Pero pag-aaral kami dito. So, ngayon, kerte ng mine, ayos na ang farming natin. So, next. Okay, ito ang isang pwede po. Cebu. Kaya nga, mga Cebuano, umalis kung tamina na. Yung puso ng mais, nahirap pa hawakan. Ang farmers na laki tao. So, That's the situation why the Cebuanos have been in the media now, including the manner of this experience. Yeah, really, huh? This from Cebu. Niwa yung Cebu, kasi ito na na, well, makakabubuhay doon. Next. No, sa forest partner, in sa same community, sa Cebu, pwede ako, bahay, makapakita na ako, niyo, okay? Ang daming bata sa loob. Sa pintuan, lima ata. Sa bintana, tatlo. Doon ko bilang bintana, baka mayroon pa. Say, this is how you see the poor people can produce more. Okay, next. Ito naman, ang mga mam yan, in the mountain at Masale or in Tamidor, sa bundok yung mga sitwisyon na yan. Ano niyo, butas-butas sa bahay. Pero marami pa rin bata ang nayari. So, yun. Pero this is the first time I saw how poor these people. And there are about 15,000 mamayans doon sa bundok ng Masalay. Next. Okay. Now, our purpose in this is we are in there and we are going to force the farmers to get rich. Pipilitin natin sila yung maman. So ito ang formula natin. Parang si Boto. KKAA, that's the farmers, Pacificity, plus Mercado, plus Pugos Ucadato. So, K, Pugues, Cebuano, Pugues, and Sipa, and work. K, Puso, Lakas, Strength, A, and Dos, E is sacrifice. A, Angko, Nasa, Prayer. So this is, we applied for sa mga Cebuano. So meron tayo, Angko, Nasa. So here in FSTP, we have spiritual conversion and material transformation. So also, we encourage them, is there that the Lord will give you when nobody else can give you. So meron tayo Mateo 7:7. Mateo verse 7, chapter 7, verse 7. Ask and you shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened to your will. Bakit hindi natin gamitin si Mateo? Nag-aantay siya. The Lord is listening to it. So, lahat ng mga farmers natin, yung mga dito, visual, marunong yan ang mga dasal, marunong mga hingi, and ang ating panito, epistipe, paano siya, yung merkado sa amin ay palingki yan. Ubusok ka dato po, friends. Okay. I formulated this in 1995 when we started the program. Now, the purpose in doing that is to make these four farmers improve their living condition. At committee natin yung mga kapanak. Okay? Next. So, ang MSTP, hindi lang mais or rice, corn based. So, that means we have corn, we have vegetable, we have sardine, banana, cattle, we have milking cow, dairy, poultry, beef, swine, and the market. Now, without the market, usually still mga nagawa ng farmers eh. So, critical ang market na mabinta nila yung ilang mais, sardine, and so forth. Next. So, how we still be operates? Ito ang mag-operate tayo. We have fish one. That's what fish is doing. So, fish one, yun ang may value formation, research exposure, technical empower. Farmer centers in the experiment, experimental plots of corn to compare the effects of organic fertilizer, intercropping and other NPM. Now, we emphasize intercropping here because if you plant only corn or only rice, pag nagbagyo, wipe out niya, walang matira. Pero kung matanim ko ng corn, tapos may kamote sa baba, pag bagyo, dapa ang mais at kamote na kadapa na. At mataas ang yield ng kamote, about 10,000 to 20,000 kilos per hectare. Yung mais, about 5-7 times na. So, meron pa silang sabi, and so on. Now, here is, they only made limit once a week and finish this and then harvest yung ayos. There will be lecture on value permission for love of God, God, real people, lecture on soil fertility, lecture on plant breeding, na matuto sila mag-breed their own varieties of corn. My lecture topic towards the end, record keeping, marketing, and association. So, complete ang setup to ensure that the farmers train are well-rounded for love of God, country, and people. Next. So, first one, matapos yan, after the harvest, the corn season broke, and did it only once a week. Itong fisto, this is now on farm trial, doon na sa farmer's field. Dadali nila yun, yung what they learn, what fertilizer, what varieties, and what crops, pwede-cropping. Doon na nila subukan sa kanilang farm. Now, kung ayaw, kung wala siyang magawa sa pisto, ang ibig sabihin niya na nakuha sa piswan, yung isna, lands, pintuhan, gusto lang magusog sa piswan. And this is just what I was happening in our training program. Isang business lang. Tapos, uwi, ihanap naman yung farmers another training. But ito, iba to. They have to go to their own farm, adapt what is best, try it there. Next. Then they go to phase 3. Now in the phase 3, this is where our motto, we gather knowledge to scatter. The farmers now are given two district research corps. They let me give it, they let me know why. These farmers, after finishing pisto, were given a specific topic na makalitso sila. So, they either use the adaptive farmer or adaptive barangay. Usually, adaptive barangay ginagamit kasi may pondo yan. Pero kung adaptive farmer, ikaw lang, involuntary yan. Kung nakuntuhan kayo, kung saan kayo, nag-araro ba kayo, tapos yung isang farmer, si Hingay ng Bine, so yan. So, everybody has a chance to learn from our graduates. Now, so you've got next phases. Okay, now, give me a success story. What's the first success story here? Corn production in Cebu has increased from 500 kilos per hectare, 0.5, to 4, no, it is 0.5 to 4 to 6 times. Tumaas na from 500 kilos to 4,000 to 6,000 kilos per hectare or more. Because of the high-yielding varieties we introduce at high rates. Next. Now, there is a footnote there that Cebu now is 74% self-sufficient corn. And poverty has gone down from 40 to 24. Okay. Okay, now you can see the effect. Before FSTP, ang liit rin kamayos kasi malaki pa kung bumamano. After FSTP, 3 or 4 times na, surplus. Surplus, surplus na, surplus na. 6, and next. I was an example of alam ang puso ng mayos compared to sa kanina yung kalaki ng dito. So it's about 4 times per hectare. Next. Okay. Nagsubra ang harvest. Ang kanyang bahay, puno, sala, kusina, sa porch. Problema, saan sila kayo matulog? Sir, saan kayo matulog? Okay. Solusyon, ibigta mo niya. So, kumita niya, kumita na siya. So ngayon, meron siya magbahay. Next. Okay. Ito si Bidig Junior sa Oslo. Ang laki ng puso ng mais, 7 tons per hectare. pagdadalawa ng puso ko yun, no? Ang income niya sa bridge na is 70,000 pesos sa isang kaya. Then, may fish papa siya, may manok papa, papa. So, mayaman na. Ubus na ka ito. Next. Oo. Yung mga mong yan, si Ihoy at si Bilbo. Sila unang mangyan na kilala ko. Kaya basta nang punta kami sa Iray, kasama sila. Hindi na nakapasok sa Iray. Nakaupo si Bilbo. Nakatingin sa mga kapila. Sir, may bundok pala kayo? Oo. Eh, pareho tayo. Ngayon, kapunta na yung bahay, palaging anak si Bilbo. Tapos mo ito sa kanya. After the fish one, palaki na po siya umayos. Pero po po siya 4 to 5 times per hectare. Pero po, Gilyo, kumusta? Sir! Marami na kami makain. At may pina, unti, dito nakabinta na siya. Okay, okay, Gilyo. May pina ka na unti. O diba, palitan natin yung bago ng habala, ang upay-upay, hindi pa pwede. Now, last week, Franco and Elby went there and they showed him making a bridge in the cornmeal that we adapted. And he requested us that they want to taste the feel of mangyans. Pero ang sulat nila ay mangyan eh. Pero wala lang puno ibigay. So, you study it, bigyan mo ng puno. At sila yung tuturo ng mga kapitbahay nila. Mangyan, gusto nila ng puno. Okay, next. Ito naman ang mga bilangan sa Alabel, ng Kaya-Kaya-Iso. Si Uyet Laguna, ito ang lakababae si Esther Dalino. Ayan, ang laki ng puso ng maas. Si Esther, dali na siyang vegetable growing at nakabinta na. So, wala nang problema. Supra, problema na lang na pupunta pa sila sa bayan, magpa-cornmeal for gusto ng fridge. So, dapat meron tayong cornmeals na nasa kanila. Next. Okay. Stories, success story number 2 na. Cause of corn production residues by 50% through introduction of bio-in, which is a microbial fertilizer bacteria ito, galing sa talahin na salit nila. Aliyo sa organic fertilizer, slide, chicken, mayor, verde, compost. So, with this use of this organic fertilizer, you can reduce corn production from 30,000 to 10,000 per hectare. Next. Okay? So, makita namin na yung bio-in talaga ginagamit ng farmers. Kaya na, may bisita namin ito. Kaya may monitoring. Titingnan kung totoo ba. O nga, totoo. Ito kaya nabaho. Bio-in plus chicken manure lang. Walang mag-bari. Ang chicken manure, ang bio-in is only 60 pesos per pack. And yun ay 6 pack per hectare. So, very cheap. Next. Now, sa potensyal na kaya ay ala ay klase sa kiko. Yes, producing is on very compost. You can produce 30 bags in 2 months. Ang kailangan niya sa lupa, as fertilizer, only 15 bags. So, yung 15 bags, ipagbili pa niya ng 200 pesos per bag. Next. Farmers income from increased zero and putting again additional income, sales and vegetables and so on. So, makita natin dito yung mga masipag in business, mayaman na talaga. I will see them next. So, we have been left here. Marshallists and agribusinesses engaged in agribusiness who are millionaires already or about to become millionaires. Number 1, ito si Juan Vicente Morena Dalagan. Before it is TV, sa Tobago ito, sa top was 178,000 ang highest in the hectares. Ngayon, ang income niya about 1,500,000 pesos na. Every Saturday, yung one loading banana export to Manila. Meron siya coconut. Very active siya. Now, ito po lang sa Jorobin. Sa Jorobin, 100,000 primero. Ngayon, pinakamayaman 13 million a year, 3 million a month. Paano nangyari yun? Siya nag-support ng undrapoy sa mga vegetable farmers sa Dalagiti at yung 100 farmers sa Putania. Lahat ng produce niya may bili. May tatlong trucks siya ngayon. Tapos originally, si Rubin, Plimore lang yun, farmers, tapos principal driver. Nung nag-join ng FSTP, kapapangasawa ang maganda, ilang dalawa, naging millionaire. Okay, so next is, ito si Alvin Montijo. Kita na ito kami, si Alvin, sa Sundundos, for our share, from Lakab, kita si kanila. At wala, sa inyong bahay, nakitira lang sa kanyang parents in law. Ngayon, after FSTP, si Arvin, siya na sa mga millionaire. Same thing as Felix Abores, Jorge Rigo, so. Now, mayroon dito si Larry Lumusan sa Tabinisan, sa Buanga del Norte. Si Larry, nag-upisa lang ng 13,000. Ngayon, 500,000 na ang millionaire. Seb, what? Tayo mo ba si Leonard Impal, si Kanyer, school graduate mo. 15,000 ang pinili namin, ngayon 144,000, taga si Pino. Now, individual, nagsabi kami ng 1,045 partner centers in Cebu, ibang barangay at bayan. Ang income before FSTP is about 10 million, 9.5. After 2-3 years, ang income nila, 20 million or more. So, increase na more than 100%. Okay, next. Here is Jorobin. Yung bahay niya, 3-story. Grocery, may farm supplies na dito. Bumili ng bagong Mitsubishi Strada. Pinakita sa akin, totoo talaga, kaya may itrabo ko dito. Okay, next. Ito, pinakayaman sa Albuquerque, Castellano. Kala ko nasa city, Cebu City ito. Nasa Bundok, after 4 hours, lapat sila mo. So si Fresh Albuquerque, may 2 hectares, 7 vegetables. Ngayon, mix. Marami siya inter-cropping diyan. Talong, kapaya, sabon. Kanya sa trap, kanya magkitab. Ayun, more millionaire na. Next. Yan. Ito sa kanya, Chinese cabbage. So, ganda. Next. Ito siya rin. Ito. Ngayon ata, gumagawa na siya ng 2-story na bahay at may truck. Every Saturday, puno ng mga vegetables siya. Ang income niya is 24,000 a week. Next. Mahina ang kapatiri. Ay, kasi, siya, alin? Isang puno yan, just 50 pesos or more. Isang kilo yan, Chinese cabbage. Next. Ito ba, si Lantixi, yung Arcao, may truck na siya. Every house, every week, pumunat mga gulay yan, fruits and so on. Ito, ayun, another thing to make. Next. Ito si Molina de Lagan, sa Tutubate, yung Molina, yung Pairo. Pero ngayon, tatlong trucks na yan. Punot ng saging, maes at soon, ship to Manila. Original eh, paano ginawa niya ito? Nag-text lang siya ng isang businessman sa pier ng Manila. So, yung superabi. Text siya na, kami, partner scientist, and then Dr. Davide, maroon akong mga saging. Ano tayo sila? Next. Yan, ang bahay na ko eh. Bahay, pisina rin ha. Kasi employed about 10 employees. So, ha? Next. Tapos, tangi. Bila, si, he's the only bilaan o pharmaceutics in the country na nakaproduce siya ng sariling hybrid. Ikros niya ang native o IPV basis ata. Ngayon, tinawag niya Tangi Hybrid. Now, Tangi Hybrid is, Tangi ngayon is the license si producer sa Alabek. Yung isang bag niya, binibili ng 1,000 per pack. Nabinta niya 100 bucks plus pay. That's 190,000. Huh? So, ang anak ngayon, Itangi, si Mekari, nag-aaral sa Southern Mindanao State University. They're graduating next year, major in economics. Okay. So, medyo about to become a millionaire na ito si Itangi. Next. So, for improving the quality of life, living standard, bagong bahay, nag-iba na, children at saka yun. Sa kanila, mabisyo talaga kapag adal yung mga anak. So here is, you know, there is father scientist Isidro Saruna sa amin, sa Agaw. Siya ang mga anak. Father siya ito. Magdaroon ng agararo yun hanggang ating gabi. Nakagawa siya ng dalawang lawyers, dalawang marine engineers, dalawang nurse, dalawang teacher, may isang midwife. Pero ang hirap talaga trabaho niya. Maglalakad niya, magbibinta na kanyang vegetables, tapos pag-uwi, binibilang niya kung magkano ang kita, paano niya makabigyan ng wisyo ko yung mga bata. At is talaga, ayun natin, is hard work. Next. Now, ito si ng pili. They call it Stipe after Stipe. Walang anak. Tatlo ang nakakuha ng college degree, isang pharmacist, isang teacher, isang optometrician. Next. Now, another four-farmers, they call it Stipe after Stipe, si Neto Manzanares. Siya ngayon, si Neto, is employed sa Argao Agriculture Office. Trained in artificial insemination. Tapos, radio announcer sa gabi. Yung anak niya, malapit na mag-graduate sa SIPO, major in political science. Baka may balak niya, maging mayor. Next. Kasi masya naman tanya sa ako. Niya ang bahay niya, after Christy, yung sa dulo ay saliling sari-sari ito. Ang anak niya na graduate sa college, sa agriculture, hindi na nag-employ, may sarili na truck, siya na ang nag-deliver na ng products sa Cebu City market. Yes. Yung sa Liti, we have isang Isidro Liti. Si Lela, maes sa mga ito. Bagong bahay. Now, ito naman si Lucia Bakulta sa Sudundo, sa Bundo. Pakita niya ang pagbahay, ang magtika. Si Baba, si Sprout, to show, to see, to, he's holding a picture of his, her son. natapos agriculture, hindi na nagtrabaho. May sarili siya business. 24,000 iwit na kanyang income. So, siya, ang bahay nila, nandiyan lahat, TV, mayroon pa na piano niya, hindi ko makita. Next. Ito, ang mga bilangan natin, mga indigenous people, lalaman din. Dati si, bilangan, part percent is Magini Barco. Kasi asawa niya, laki ng bahay. Dalawang anak niya nakagraduate sa college. Teacher sa Dana Kuhan. No? Okay. Eh, restoration of peace and order in NPA and insurgency area. Ito ang dapat gamitin natin sa areas ng mga insurgency and NPA areas. In Cebu, doon, puno ng NPA yung north and south. At ngayon, ang military, NPA military counter only 2005 years of counter. Tatlong military namatay. Tapos, ang mga farmers na train natin sa PCP. Ngayon, mayaman ng mga farmers yung SBP, Infantry Battalion, nasa Occidental Negros na. All towns under FSTP in the Sur, Visayas, Mindanao, generally, and they're generally peaceful. Farmers are now living in peace and prosperity. Our area in Bundok Peninsula, where we have built municipalities, used to be certain PE around. Now farmers are now living in peace and prosperity there. And the military, infantry battalion, nasa ibang lugar. Next. Okay, now, to example. Cebu chose a PSTP for base, peace, war, Iraq, or peace with the PSTP. Now, when we were in Dak, Costilla Valley, the meeting was mga farmers. Mayroon sergeant na sumama. Sabi ko, sergeant, bakit nandito ka? Sir, civil affairs ako. Okay. Isang magasin ng Arbalay, magkano ang cost? That's 1,500 pesos. Huh? Isang magasin na, ilang millions yan na yun. And that 1,500 pesos, you can buy organic fertilizer that can fertilize 1 hectare of corn or vegetable. Now, dito yung nag-forest yan, ahawak niya na, hindi baril, kung hindi, puso ng mais. Ang itong may orange at diesel, that's Mayor Wilfredo Manero. Mayor is a congressman of Sucre District. Next. Our sixth introduction of strict leadership programs, especially in the cooperative association. Marami sa kanila nag-produce na banana chip, promoted chip, corn, cocoa, squash. So, they have their own marks. So, you can see some of the scriptures. Ayan sa Parmesan na ito si Lina Rapusa, taga sa Cotabato, at Tabacay. Pero na siya, banana chips. Yung una, pinyato or mani, kaya ako lang mani, kung ano, yung boss, marami siyang kita dito sa banana chip. Next. Okay, ito naman sa San Francisco, San Andres, yung dungo ng Quito province ako. Produce na sila ng coffee, corn rich. And then, maroon sila yung association nila, very active. Ito, maroon sila ng charcoal stove. May kasaba, granulitos, mayroon corn drives, kaya focus yung production building. So, yan yung good business na. Next. No, ito ang mga officers, farmers and officers ng San Andres, farmers and association. Ito sila ginagamit ng mga FSTV, graduate ng San Andres sila, para technician na kasi isa lang ang mom, siya ay technician, siya rin technician, yung si Agnes, maagbay, yung grade, siya rin mag-isa. Na kung walang FSTV, talaga mo na magawa ang bayan dyan. Next. Okay. FSTP has already trained more than 70,000 farmers nationwide. And yet, none of them has been reported for any criminal acts. They no longer complain on lack of food to eat. Their surplus farm products like corn, vegetable, fruit and fruit crops and animal products are sold to local markets, thus increasing their income above poverty. Next. Now, here are examples of part of the 70,000. Ito ang mga graduates, about 200 farmer scientist graduates, and 81 of them are Bilaan from Alabel, Sangane. Okay, so more farmers are now have gone the FSTP training in most of the towns. So their number is increasing every year. Cebu, more than 1,000 farmers graduate from the FSTP program a year. Next. Our next example in Cebu, farmers, scientists or FSTPs were funded by the governor. The governor has appropriated the money to 1 million for every town and cities to support the FSTP program. So there are about 40 million Cebu on the street. So we had a farmers congress, 9th farmers congress last November. About 2,000 farmers attended and the governor gave them cornmeals, planters, then there was a truck full of sweet potato at kasama bodies. When they went home, they have planting potatoes already. Now, FSTP improves the farmers' leadership. Many of them have become officials at local government units, like barangay captains, municipal councillors, and others acting as agricultural technicians or as FSTP municipal coordinators. And nine, FSTP involves and enhances the research and extension capabilities of NGO and state colleges and universities. So many of our mouse technicians are really empowered and they can improve their extension of capabilities. Now, colleges and universities, the Cebu State College of Science and Technology, due to their active participation in the state, you know, they were able to convert their state colleges to university at Cebu. To Cebu Technical University. Next. Okay. Discoveries by farmer scientists. Several of them have developed and produced their own hybrid corn and open pollinated varieties like Angina to supply their own seeds and sell their surplus product to field farmers. Now, we have been receiving reports that corn seeds supplied by the regional office of DA, that is from Mindanao to Cebu or other places, they are no longer viable. So there are cases that 500 bucks will be the facility as a Cebu. So ngayon, this is the solution. Let the farmers produce their own seeds. Now, ito si Felipe de Oso, so San Andres Mission. He discovered that yung seaweeds, sinablay sa mais, ang control ng corroborates of this. Now, Dr. Palumpang has a research program from Digiba. Ito pala ang serum day to have 9 chemicals that will repair, repeal the insects. So, hindi na pupunta ang insect. Repeal it. Yeah. Next. There is Serida Puyakot Apukul. Ang gamit siya ng seawater as fertilizer sa mani. Now, because of her curiosity sa pisto, pumunta yan sa kabinda pa. Nakita na yung new coconut ang taba-taba. So, it's coconut. Ang kanyang crop is peanut. So, coconut ang peanut. May pikto ang seawater. So, sinubukan niya. So, isang cup ng seawater at saka ay request sa ramit. Maganda, 100% increase na niya. So, ngayon, Gable has a research plan to us. And we found that 50% seawater can produce a yield of peanut and corn more than 50%. So, that's it. Very cheap fertilizer when you see all that. Yes. Now, a hybrid seed. This is Florencia Mupia. Because I can have Mupia, sige, sige, bago ito. Si Barber said, is Dimo. Dimo. Daga, sultan ko dada. Burumbayan, sultan ko dada. Ito, very hybrid. Now, the risk and job of yoking the extinction stuff. The real extinction talaga nakasitupi. And here is Ms. Wilma Velasco. Ms. Wilma, punta sa San Jose, walang ibang paraan. Hindi ganang Asia o sa sakay ng Balikud. Next. Si Mel Makanoy naman yung sa mga mangyan. Bahat pa yung mga mangyan yun. Walang ibang daan na kundi yung kunting butas sa dalawang bato. Full house niya yung matapagod. Next. Ako naman, ako sumasama talaga. I have to find out how hard is this extinction work. Kaya parili, wala kami tulay. Tapos, irrigation plant yan. Okay? Dahan-dahan, hina-hina, ang hawak ko, kamera yan. I always carry kamera, pero si Tommy ang magkakang sa akin. Ang hirap talaga. Next. Now, misa sakay ko ng kapalhaban ni Tommy. Isang beses na kapalhaban kami sa tampakay, papuntang bundok o bilaan sa Baratay Tablo. Sakay kami ng motor at marami yung cup ko. Huwag niya sa amin, pasagdan. Tapos, naplotahan niya. Then, transfer ko na sa ibang motor. Pak-pak-pak-pak-pak-pak-pak-pak-pak. Ito na yan. Anong nangyari nito? Kasi may tubig yung gasolina na ito. Ayun. Pero naayos naman. Next. Oh, pibili. Wala na sakyan. May kalabaw. Kasi nakyan yung kalabaw. So, pibili. Pinas niya na. Pag-pibili. Iba naman sa amin, sakay ng kabayo. Wala kabayo. So, one horsepower, pwede na magamit kung nabukin. Next. Si Mel, makasabi ng barog to, kaya niyo ng palo. Next. Okay. Ito, makita ko ang lugar na napuntahan ko. Isa nito yung sumit na ilog. Tapos kami ng ilog, walang panuto eh. So, nakakasunod. Kita mo nga, hinawakan ko yung aking sapatos, baka masira. Hindi na bali yung paa ko. Then, sa ibaba, yung jeep, puno na puti, itulak namin. No, yeah. So, it's the rest, no? So, with our mission spirit, we made our community service highly successful, as you can see. So, thank you, and God bless us all.